All right, remember I went to Orlando for the Star Wars convention?
Yes.
I was in that brutally difficult assignment at a really nice hotel in Orlando.
Yes.
Oh, I remember that. Yeah, you
and I ran into Sarah there. And see, we vacationed, not together, but...
Well, he came back and told us he vacationed with Sarah.
We did. We had a cocktail. We did the Lazy River. I mean, that essentially, that constitutes a vacation.
How annoying was it for you to run into him?
Well, considering we're neighbors in L.A., I mean, it's kind of like,
damn.
Again?
And speaking of which, one of the local markets, your food store is the end cap at Gelson's.
Yeah.
It's everywhere.
7,500 stores as of
this
month.
That's amazing.
Wow. Yeah.
And you were on the phone with Jewel Osco yesterday?
Yeah, I mean, it's a day-to-day thing. It's not something that you can give up to someone else. I mean, it's my baby. It's, you know, if I'm going to get it done right, I do it myself.
Wow. We're going to get into all that in just a second, but let me show you what is dominating all of social media. This picture that you took, you went out. And you ran into your friend Selma Blair.
I know, it's a miracle. I actually went out on a Monday night. It was shocking. Can you tell I took the picture? It's slightly blurry, but yes. it was so random. And what was even funnier was that people don't know is I was getting dressed and I was asking my husband, like, what do you think of this outfit? And he's like, I'm not your girlfriend. He's like, fine, pretend I'm James. That's what I call Selma. He's like, I kind of look like her. And it channeled her, and then she showed up at the event. It was so random.
Wow. Okay.
So next time I'm going to channel cooler weather.
See what he says about that. Speaking of your husband, 20th anniversary of I Know What You Did Last Summer. And did you guys meet on the set of that movie?
We did.
Okay.
We did.
We can't believe it's 20 years. We were just talking about this yesterday.
You can't believe?
I know.
You can't believe?
Yeah. Right?
It's a long time ago.
More Sarah Social. Here's the cute montage of you and Freddie.
Oh, great.
Aww. Very cute.
There we go.
I know what happened to me.
No.
Yeah. Same.
All right, so you've got a cookbook out, you have the food stores out, and then you're doing a partnership with Capital One?
Yes, I am. It was, so much of what I talk about with food stores is not just the idea of, you know, having the cleanest and greenest and most sustainable baking, but it's about the moments that you create in a kitchen, right? We're so digitally connected. You and I talk about this all the time. Like, what are the moments when you put your phone down and you have eye contact? And minus being on a news program in the morning, which I'm sure not everybody is on every morning, to me, it's always around food. It's either you're at a restaurant and you're dining, or you're in the kitchen and you're cooking. Mm-hmm. And what are those moments? And Capital One came up with this card, the Saver card, which basically rewards you with cash for doing something that you're already doing. I mean, it's like literally the most genius thing. And it's rose gold, which is my favorite color, so I can actually see it in my wallet. I am not Liam cardholder, though.
Okay. As sometimes cards are affiliated with airlines, it's affiliated with food.
Well, the thing with the airlines is, like, we sit there and we accrue miles and we watch it sit there and then we never use them.
True.
And then by the time we use them, it's like 200,000 trillion miles to go somewhere. And it's like you're basically wasting it. So the idea of this card is you get 3% back when you go to restaurants, 2% on shopping, including foodstores.com, if you're watching. Right. Throwing that out there. And 1% on other shopping. So the idea is your money can make money while you're creating those memories, and then you'll have more money to make more memories. It's really just about connection. Again, it all comes back to that, savoring those moments that you're together.
Back to foodstores for a second. I think it's so interesting. You know, they talk about this in show business. The audience is always right. So have your customers said to you, I'm just making this up, we like this flavor better than this flavor, we like this recipe more than that recipe?
100%. I mean, I think that's one of the reasons why we have our online component. Yes, we're now available in all these stores. You can go to Target and you can get it, or you can go here. But the idea is, look at Charlotte when she was so little. Yeah. The idea is that through the internet, you really get that direct consumer feedback. So we always test new recipes and new mixes in our online component first so that we have that direct relationship. But we can say this is going to work. So for instance, our pancakes are just hitting shelf. We have the most sustainable organic pancakes on the market. We have regular and we have pumpkin spice. But we test them online first and hear the thoughts. Luckily, the feedback was 99.999% positive. I think the negative was probably just my family.
Do you first test them on the kids?
Always test on family and friends.
Yeah.
Like, you know, I'm surprised I haven't, like,
I know, come on, like, drive. Why don't you drop off a thing of pumpkin spice pancakes? So, like, what is the top, like, seller? I'm just curious.
It changes. Right now, chocolate chip cookie, because it's the easiest, and that's a big one. But I think pancakes are going to soon overtake, because they're so easy.
Wow. Like, see, it's a race. I want to be in the corporate board that sees, like, the lines move. All things Sarah working on. You can follow her on Twitter at Sarah M. Gellar, and check out Foodstores at foodstores.com.
And the Saver card available now.
There it is. She got it all in. Nice to see you.
Thank you, Sarah.
Thank you for having me.